Nihil ultu, re since Christ is preached as raised from the dead, how is it that some of you say there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, Christ himself has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, our preaching is void of content, and your faith is empty too. Indeed, we should then be exposed as false witnesses of God, for we have borne witness before him that he raised Christ, but he certainly did not raise him up if the dead are not raised. Why? Because if the dead are not raised, then Christ was not raised. And if Christ was not raised, your faith is worthless. You are still in your sins, and those who have fallen asleep in Christ are the deadest of the dead. If our hopes in Christ are limited to this life only, we are the most pitiable of men. But as it is, Christ is now raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. Death came through a man. Hence the resurrection of the dead comes through a man also. Just as in Adam all died, so in Christ all will come to life again, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits, and then at his coming, all those who belong to him. After that will come the end, when after having destroyed every sovereignty, authority, and power, he will hand over the kingdom to God the Father. Christ must reign until God has put all his enemies under his feet, and the last enemy to be destroyed is death. Scripture reads that God has placed all things under his feet. But when it says that everything has been made subject, it is clear that he who has made everything subject to Christ is excluded. When finally, all has been subjected to the Son, he will then subject himself to the one who made all things subject to him, so that God may be all in all. If the dead are not raised, what about those who have themselves baptized on behalf of the dead? If the rise of the dead is not a reality, why are we baptized on their behalf? And why are we continually putting ourselves in danger? I swear to you, brothers, by the very pride you take in me, which I cherish in Christ Jesus our Lord, that I face death every day. If I fought those beasts at Ephesus for purely human motives, what profit was there for me? If the dead are not raised, let us eat and drink, for tomorrow we die. Do not be led astray any longer. Bad company corrupts good morals. Return to reason as you ought, and stop sinning. Some of you are quite ignorant of God. I say this to your shame. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Christ must reign until God has brought all enemies under his feet.
The last day of the week is the Lord's day. Hallelujah. summoned by Saint Anastasius of Antioch. To this end, Christ died and rose to life, that he might be Lord of both of the living and the dead. But God is not a God of the dead, but of the living. That is why the dead, now under the dominion of the one who has risen to life, are no longer dead, but alive. Therefore, life has dominion over them, just as Christ, having been raised from the dead, will never die again, so too they will live forever and they will never fear death again. When they have been thus raised from the dead and freed from decay, they shall never again seek death, for they will share in Christ's resurrection, just as he himself shared in their death. That is why Christ descended into the underworld with its imperishable prison bars, to shatter the doors of bronze and to break the bars of iron, and from decay to rise to life to himself by giving us freedom in place of servitude. But if this plan does not yet appear to be perfectly realized, for all men still die and bodies still decay in death, this should not occasion any loss of faith. For in receiving the first fruits, we have already received the pledge of all the blessings we have mentioned. With them we have reached the heights of heaven, and we have taken our place beside him who has raised us up with himself. As Paul says, in Christ, God has raised us up with him and has made us sit with him in the heavenly places. And the fulfillment will be ours on the day predetermined by the Father, when we shall put off our childish ways and come to perfect manhood. For this is the decree of the Father of the ages. The gift once given is to be secure and no more to be rejected by a return to childish attitudes. There is no need to recall that the Lord rose from the dead with a spiritual body, since Paul, in speaking of our bodies, bears witness that they are sworn as animal bodies and raised as spiritual bodies. That is, we are transformed in accordance with the glorious transfiguration of Christ, who goes before us as our leader. The apostle, affirming something he clearly knew, also said that this would happen to all mankind through Christ, who will change our lowly bodies to make it like his glorious body. If this transformation is a change into a spiritual body and one, furthermore, like the glorious body of Christ, then Christ rose with a spiritual body, a body that was sown in dishonor, but the very body that was transformed in glory, having brought this body to the Father as the first fruits of all of our nature, he will also bring the whole body to fulfillment. For he promised this when he said, when I am lifted up, I will draw all men to myself.
Dead shall rise.
Those who are sons of the dead.
sun shall not smite you, nor the moon in the night.
The Lord will guard you from evil. He will guard your soul. The Lord will guard your going and coming, both now and forever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will guard your soul. Alleluia. If you kept a record of our sins, Lord, who could escape condemnation? Alleluia. Out of the depths of